بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My name is ميساء مبارك سعيد الخربوشي. Today I'm going to present about my project, which is crop yield recommendation. The table of content will be those as shown here. And I will speak about introduction of my project, which is about agriculture, not only fulfills the human basic needs, but also considered as source of employment in developing countries. Employing machine learning with a good model of predicting the suitable crop to grow, which depends on many factors that affect the crop yield, such as rainfall and pH of soil, temperature, will affect directly on the crops. The scope of works is to make it easy for farmers and companies who want to invest in agriculture sector, and by implementing machine learning and algorithm and predicting model for analyzing the most feature will have an impact upon crop growth. The data set used from Kaggle, and we will use Google Colab and Python in this project. And the result will be prediction algorithm with accuracy of 99%. Here is the CRISP DM we implemented in this project, and the steps will be in detail in the next slide. So we have first to understand the business. The problem is some farmers and companies invest in this sector needs to manage the crop's quality by knowing which factor is affecting the crop's growing well. So this will lead to increase profit and keep quality of yield crops. Here the data understanding and the metadata of the data set that we used, like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, temperature, humidity, pH of soil, rainfall, in millimeter, and crops which is will be available, and it is categorical for 22 crops. So we'll move to Colab. Here we'll start to answer question number 3, which is about exploratory data analysis. First we will start to upload and import libraries of pandas. Second, we'll do some exploratory data analysis, such as the metadata of data set. Here, the metadata of data set, and we can find that that data having 2,200 columns and eight attributes. And here we also continue with EDA process. Here some function for description of the data. And we also implying is null function to see any missing value in the attributes, and we don't find any missing value. And we apply also a unique function to see if there is samples like question mark or another things. For crops as a label and a categorical, we find 22 categories in the crop. Here also the division of the crops, which is have 22, like rice, maize, cotton, coconut, watermelon, and so on. And here some visualization data for the crops. Also handling, here question number 4. Here, question number four, we continue to see the missing replacing non-value in the data set and also applying heat map to see if there is any null value. So we can see if there is no null value in our data set and our data set is clean. We apply, continue with the EDA process, and we see here the heat map correlation between the attributes. We find that some positive correlation and some negative correlation between the attributes like rainfall and humidity, nitrogen have positive correlation, and pH soil and rainfall, humidity, temperature, potassium, phosphorus have negative correlation. Here we also continue with ADA process to view some correlation between labels, which is crops, and some features like phosphorus. We can find that from the figure, amount of phosphorus increase to 120 and 140, the crop grow will be less. Here another relation we also test between the attributes. Another things, some descriptive statistics like the average, some facts about the features which affect on the crops, like the ratio of nitrogen and average ratio of rainfall. Next, we can see some distribution of agriculture condition. We visualize them to see the distribution of agriculture condition. We from the finding we can observe that some crops require modest amount of nitrogen, while other need an average of amount of nitrogen, and the other crops require a big amount, and so on. Here also we find some facts from the data, like which crops require high nitrogen. We find cotton, and also applies crops which require low pH. We find mut beans, and so on. Here also to understand the data set more, we apply some data. We apply this function like dividing the summer crop, winter crop, rainy crops. Here we apply the machine learning model by classifying. We use key means clustering, and we use elbow method to determine the k, which is we find it it's equal to number 4. And here the clustering process for the key means. Also we apply hierarchical clustering. As you can see the dendrogram plots, and here the cluster for the hierarchical cluster, and here the visualization for key means clustering with 4 cluster. Also here we build predictive modeling. We use almost 5 models. Key neighbors, KNN, decision tree, random forest, and grounded boosting, and XG boost. We find that accuracy of random forest is most higher than the we can discuss the result of the predicting models here. So we can see that random forest, gradient boosting, and XG boot have the higher accuracy rate, which is 99%. Second, decision tree will come by 98%. And last one is KNN by 97%. Also, we can see here as we can the confusion matrix. And here real-time prediction, which is speak about it last time. For to conclude this project and future work also, we can find that machine learning can predict the crop yield based on given data. In this project, we find that random forest GP and XGB models are the highest in the accuracy by 99% in terms of accuracy. And the future world can implement MLL techniques like CVM, neural network, to achieve high accuracy by equal to 99 or more. And thank you and good luck.